All right, time now for Consumer Confidential with KTLA 5's David Lazarus.
He is joining us here in the studio on Friday, but kind of starting out with something negative in terms of the inflation. A lot of people are having to dip into their savings.
Yeah, and it's not just that. They're dipping into their rainy day funds. And this is a dangerous game, although for many families who are living paycheck to paycheck, what choice do they have? A new report from New York Life Insurance finds that roughly a third of U.S. adults who maintain emergency funds for that proverbial rainy day have cut back on their contributions because they need more liquid cash to just meet their day-to-day expenses, going to the grocery store, going to the gas pump. According to the report, the average monthly contribution is down by as much as $243. This is the latest indication that the current inflation rate of 8.3% is forcing many households to rethink their finances, at least temporarily. But in the case of rainy day funds, well, when that rainy day arrives, if you don't have the funds, then you're facing extra trouble. So that's a real mixed bag. The report also finds that about a third of adults are putting off vacations because of rising inflation, and about 22% are putting off purchasing a car. So we're seeing a lot of ancillary effects related to rising consumer prices.
All right, we've seen this before. H&M paying big to settle a case over unused gift cards.
Big chunk of change we're talking about here. H&M, the big fast fashion retailer, agreeing to pay $36 million to New York authorities over having kept, according to New York authorities, about $18 million in unused gift card balances in their own bank accounts, rather than turning them over to New York authorities, as they're supposed to do, as unclaimed property. So this settlement, while it happens in New York, is a reminder for all people to make sure you're looking after any unclaimed cash or property. Here in California, unclaimed gift card balances, there's no expiration date, nor for gift certificates. So you don't have to worry about them running out. Also, there can't be any dormancy fees if you're not using the cards. Nevertheless, money that's or gift cards that are just simply kept in the drawer unused is money that you're basically handing to a retailer for nothing. Go to KTLA.com in a few minutes and I'll have a link for you that'll show you how you can run a free search to find out if there's any cash or property in your name.
Oh, that's fun. Mm. All right. And then what is this big step in the fight against plastic pollution?
This is a good thing. It's a small step, but it's an important step. Coca-Cola coming up with a new cap for its plastic bottles that is tethered to the bottle so that when you open it and open the cap there, you can see it right there. It doesn't come away. You can't throw it in the gutter. You can't just toss it onto the sidewalk. It stays with the bottle. The idea here is that if you're going to be recycling the bottle, and you should, the cap will go away along with it. This is important because plastic waste accounts for about 400 million tons of trash that typically ends up in oceans and waterways and elsewhere. That's a big problem. So even though this is a very small step towards a solution, it is a step. However, Coke is only unveiling this in Britain at the moment. I haven't seen any plans for it to be introduced in America. They could be anticipating that Americans don't want a cap next to their bottle, and they may be right.
Get it in the way of the drink.
It could, but nevertheless, a small price to pay for saving the planet.
Exactly.